start to low count. A kid got choked out, bones were thrown, and a fucking fight broke out. It's gonna happen, like a motherfucker. The thing was air, like, come on, motherfucker. Can we just all get along so I can put pinkies on a chest like little Sean? Get a pissy drunk on my...
I'm Tyler Miller. In high school, I played football, baseball, and halfway through high school, I threw shot put, discus, hammer, got pretty good at it. Went to Purdue on a track and field scholarship, and with the throws, obviously lifting heavy is a really important part of what you do. So that's the weightlifting, powerlifting, strongman background that I have all comes from that. Strongman's role in Force Barbell is kind of one of our three main components in our lifting competition squad. We call it our strength squad, powerlifting, strongman, and weightlifting. Basically, we do it because it's fun. It's a great way to train and stay competitive at something post. You know, we've got a lot of people who are high school athletes and team sports and don't have any way to get that competitive, competitive itch scratched after they're done with their high school career, and just want to keep training, keep lifting, get as strong as they can, push themselves as hard as they can. So that strongman kind of fills that void for people. One of the reasons that I really love the strength squad sports, weightlifting, powerlifting, strongman, is because the community is second to none. It reminds me of my throwing days where you're competing against everybody, but it's really an individual competition, so you're really competing with yourself, with other people there. So it's a really cool atmosphere where you're competing against other people, but everybody wants you to do the best that you can that day as well. So it's very supportive, very uplifting. Everybody's willing to take in new people and show them the ropes and kind of teach them how to do things a little bit better and just support everybody and get everybody the best they can be.
I am the president and owner of United States Strongmen. We've been in business now for almost 2 years. We're going into the end of our second year as of June 11th, which will be our second nationals. This year will be in Louisville, Kentucky on 4th Street Live, which will be crazy. We're expecting maybe 200 athletes this year. It's going to be pretty big. Last year we had 128, so I could definitely see us go up. This is my 31st year of strength sports. I started powerlifting in 1985, did that through 1997, and then I started doing strongman in 1998 to current. So this is my 31st year, 52 years old, getting ready to retire from teaching for 30 years so I can do this full time. So I actually still get paid and I don't even have to work. So I'm looking forward to that. Continue to help strongmen grow, help guys and girls get to the next level. Masters, we're doing stuff for the juniors now with the first ever spot we're going to give out at USS Nationals for a junior world strongman spot in Ireland in August. So we're trying to cover the whole spectrum. If athletes want to go to the next level, we're going to do everything we can to help get them there. The strongman community is the best community. You know, it's one of the few sports that you can be competing against somebody and helping each other out. You know, it's, you know, guys, if somebody does 10 reps on the log, you know, they're gonna say, you know, next guy, all right, I got 10, now you go get 11. And if you need a belt, they're gonna loan you their belt. They'll loan you their straps. I mean, there's no sport like strongman, strongwoman. The best community, everybody's supportive. You know, it's exciting to be around. It's so much fun. If anybody is thinking about doing strongman, don't wait. People all the time ask me, I need to train for a year or two before I compete. No, you don't. Go do contests. That's the best training out there.
What you heard is what you hearing. What you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. X gon' give it to you. What? Wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock. Open up the door. It's real. With the non-stop party. can I do it again? Cause yeah. I am life, so I got to win. Break bread with the enemy. No matter how many cats I break bread with, I break who you send to me. You motherfucker never wanted nothing but your life saved. That's on a life day, I'm getting down, down. Like it said, freeze. I won't be the one ending up on his knees. Please, if the only thing you can't steal was came out to play, stay out my way. Mother, first we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go. What? X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. First we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. He ain't never gave nothing to me, but every time I turn around, cats got their hands out, wanting something from it. I ain't got it, so you can't get it. Yeah. Let's leave it at that, cause I ain't with it. Yeah. Hit it with full strength. What? I'm a jail, so I face the world like a girl in the bullpen. You against me against you. Whatever, whenever, you gon' do. I'm a wolf in sheep clothing. What? Only that you know who can chill. Come back and get the streets open. I've been doing this for 19 years. What? Wanna fight me? Fight these tears. What? I put in work and it's all for the kids. But these cats done forgot what work is. They don't know who we be looking, but they don't know who they see. First we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. First we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go. Come on. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. Hey yo, where am I? Dad, I know I got him down in the greens. Give him love and they give it back. Joke too much for too long. What? Don't give up, you're too strong. What? Love to the wild, wild hunters. Yeah. Shout out to that done it. Come on. And it ain't even about the dough. It's about getting down for what you stand for, yo.
You're almost halfway on the team. And if you're starting off with a higher arm,
Hi, I'm Dr. Todd McDougall. I've been involved in Strongmen since about 1998. Done a lot of really great things at the request of Chad Coy initially. Chad Coy is a professional Strongman athlete. We've been, you know, good friends for a long time. Of course, you know, he's been my guinea pig. And with that, there was a question that was asked many years ago of him, and he said, listen, he says, you know, I'm tired of feeling like I'm getting sprung, you know, after I get an adjustment. And then, of course, you know, you're waiting 12 to 24, 48 hours, and then, you know, then I can finally go ahead and do my strength sports. So he's like, you know what, Todd, he says, why don't you come up with some way to make it to where I don't have that sprung sensation. So I was like, okay, well, you know, I trained with him, and of course, you know, with me, I actually was handicapped back in 1988, so I almost lost an arm, missing half my bicep, brachialis is gone, I'm missing both lats out of my back, so kind of makes me skinny, you know, for the most part. In fact, that's what Chad often called me over the years, is like, hey, skinny, how about helping me out? So, but anyway, it felt good to go ahead and use Chad Coy as my lab rat over these many years. And of course, you know, other strength athletes as well. And, you know, come up with a technique that's very, very unique, I guess, if you will. What we've done is in lieu of information that came in the mid 1990s, whereas they were talking about performance reduction with stretching, and of course hyperreactivity of the stretch receptors, doing pre-activity, if you will, would actually cause there to be a decrease in performance. So it just so happened that came about the same time that Chad asked me to go ahead and come up with a new strategy. And so, utilizing Gonstead techniques, utilizing Thompson-type tables, and, my interpretation of those things, and of course, thinking outside the box, which was allowed to me as I, was handicapped and working with, the school, Palmer College of Chiropractic at the time, really kind of allowed me the opportunity to think outside of the box and come up with something new. And so now what we see is with the McDougall Chiropractic Methods, and that's what we're calling it, we're seeing a 20% gain in power immediately off the table. There's no refractory time. There's no downtime. We're talking immediately right off the table. In fact, you can hear the noise right now. So we've got some things happening here because we've got a contest just today. And this is a really pretty much a typical thing that we see with strength athletes is we saw a 75-pound PR in 18-inch deadlift. A gentleman actually was able to go ahead and do 805 in practice. He did an 880-pound lift today from 18 inches and is just so excited. And of course, then he also had the same contest, a 20-pound personal record as well in the log press. This is the neat thing of, you know, being able to work with, you know, the strength sports, being able to go ahead and take some knowledge, being able to go ahead and address the needs of the athletes and allow them, you know, the freedom to get rid of the restriction that causes them to, you know, have a decrease in performance. It's neat to change that. You know, it's hard to believe that I've been doing this now, like I said, since 1998, and have been able to take care of multiple World Strongest Man champions. Been able to rub elbows with people like Magnus Vermagason and Ode Haugen as well. Brian Shaw, of course, you know, Zydrunas Zivikas, and, you know, so many of these other people that are, you know, basically legends within our time. And I feel very, very blessed. A lot of people ask if I want to get paid when I go ahead and I go to these events. And you know, for the most part, I don't. You know, I mean, for me, it's an opportunity to go ahead and make an impact in the sport, but also at the same time to represent my profession as a chiropractor. I want to see my profession, you know, have some longevity. And unfortunately, these days, a lot of people are doing everything except the adjustment. And it's fun when people come up to you after they've watched you and they say, you know what, I went on that table. I want to feel what you're doing, you know? And it's crazy because in chiropractic, it's become my niche. Who would ever thought that my niche would be doing an adjustment as a chiropractor, right? So anyway, those are just some thoughts, you know, as we go ahead and we go along. You know, I love what I do. I love the strength sports. I love working with people. And I'm very, very fortunate to be able to go ahead and work with a wide variety of different amateur and professional athletes. And, you know, that's why I do what I do.
And do you have any like, contact info if people want to get involved?
You can go to the website, unitedstatesstrongman@gmail.com, for any questions. We're on Facebook also. The nice thing, one thing we do is on the Gmail account, there's three of us on the same account. So you may not get an answer from me, you might get it from Mike, you might get it from John, you might get it from me. But we check it all the time, so you're not waiting for an answer. You can get it pretty quick.
All right, awesome.